Hi there, welcome back. Let's talk about inner joy using data manipulation language. So for this video, you will learn what is inner joy as well as two methods to perform inner joy. So for inner joy, normally we have two tables with different data, but they have some columns that match. And when these tables are joined based on the matching columns, the rows where data matches in both tables are kept, whereas the rows where data doesn't match are left out. Like finding the common parts in two things and keeping only those parts while ignoring the rest. Now let's get one inner joy example to understand better. So for example, we have two tables. We want to know which student takes database 101 on 20220101. So this is the first table, and then this is the second table. So for the first table here, this is the student table, and then we have student ID, student name, and city. And the next table is student record. So we have student ID, course name, and course date. So for this question, basically we want to get the name of the student who actually takes database 101 on this particular date. So how do we do that? So let's start with the manual way first. So first of all, we'll look at this student record table. So first of all, database 101, and then on this particular date. So which row actually matches this condition? It will be the third row here. So this third row actually matches this condition here. And what is the student ID? The student ID is actually 7 here, but this question is asking for the student name. So we have to get this student ID, and then we go to student table to actually find out who has the student ID 7. So if we take this student ID 7 and we come to this table here, so who has the student ID of 7? It will be Ali here. So the answer is actually Ali here. So this is a manual way using two-step process. But what if you want to combine these two steps into one single step using inner join? It's actually quite simple. So first of all, we'll find the common column for these two tables. So what are the common columns for these two tables? It will be student ID. It means that we have student ID in table 1 as well as student ID in table 2. So using these two common columns, we can actually join both of the tables. So when I join both of the tables using this student ID column, we'll get this final result here. So you can think of this result on the right here, it's like a big table that joins both student and the student record table using the student ID as the common column. So let's look at the result here. So the blue box here is actually from student record table, and the green box here is actually from the student table, and they both join using the student ID column. So if you look at this, remember that we only keep things that are common for both of the table. So the result only show student ID with 6 and 7. So what happens with 5? So where is the row for 5? So for student ID with 5, because this student ID with 5 only appears in student table, it will not appear in the final table because we do not have the student ID 5 in the student record table. Therefore, the final result will only show student ID 6 and 7 after doing the inner join. So a reminder again, we only keep things that are common for both tables. Things that are not common, we will just discard away. So this is the temporary result after combining both of the tables. And if we want to solve this question, it's actually quite simple now. So first of all, we look at the question. Database 101, this belongs to which column? It belongs to the course name column. And where does the course name columns come from? It comes from the student record table. It means that I will do my filter based on the course name column from the student record table later. And where is this particular date? This particular date comes from the course date column. And where does course date column come from? It comes from the student record table. So it means that I will filter out my result based on the course name and the course date column from the student record table. And what do we want? We want the student name. So we will select the student name from the student table from this green box here. So what happens in the final query is I will select the student name from the student table, and then maybe I will select the course name and the course date column from the student record table, and then I will do an inner join based on a common column for both of the tables, which is student ID, and then finally I will put a where clause to specify my condition, which is database 101 and 20220101. Now let's look at the answer line by line. So the first line is, as usual, select statement. So select student dot student name. It means that I'm actually selecting student name from this student table. Therefore, we have this dot notation here. Student dot student name, and then comma student record dot course name. It means that selecting the course name column from the student underscore record table, and then course date from the student record table. So this is for the first line. And then from student inner join student record. So these are the two tables that we will be using for inner join. Definitely some of my students always ask me, does the arrangement matter? It means, does it matter if I put student underscore record table first or student table first for this inner join? The answer is, it doesn't matter. You can either put student underscore record table first or student table first. It doesn't matter. And next, let's go to the fourth line. On student.student ID, it means that this student ID column comes from the student table. Equal to student underscore record dot student ID. It means this column comes from the student underscore record table. This is how you can do inner join based on a particular column. And finally, let's specify the condition where student underscore record dot course name equal to database 101 and student underscore record dot course date equal to 20220101. So this is how you can specify the where condition. We say that this course name comes from this student record table and this course date comes from this student underscore record table. And then we'll just end the statement with a semicolon. So this is a step-by-step guide on doing inner join. First of all, you'll find a common column and then you'll specify a condition and then you'll select the column that you want. And finally, you'll just write down the query. It's actually quite straightforward once you know the logic. So after running this query, it will return the result highlighted in the green box here. So Ali for the student name here, and then database 101 for the course name here, and then 20220101 for the course date here. And definitely we also have method 2, which does the same thing, just in different form. So the first line is the same as the method 1, select student.studentName, studentRecord.CourseName, studentRecord.CourseDate. And the second line is from student, comma, student underscore record. So it's a bit different from method 1. For method 1, we have used the keyword inner join, but for method 2, we can just put comma. It means that we are selecting columns from these two tables. Therefore, we can just put a comma. And the third line is specifying the condition. So course name equal to database 101 and course date is equal to 20220101. Now we just have to look at the last line. So and student.studentID equal to student underscore record.studentID and then semicolon. So this is the other way of joining both tables using similar column using the and statement. So feel free to use method 1 or method 2 to do inner join depending on which one you prefer. It doesn't really matter because they do the same thing. So let's look at one partial question to test your understanding on inner join. So a relational database technology stores data about the staff in the company and the computer devices used by the staff. The database has the following tables. So staff, staff ID, first name, last name, date of birth, job title. So staff ID is the primary key for the staff table. And then we have device, device ID, type, date purchase, staff ID. So this staff ID is actually a foreign key in this device table because this staff ID is actually linked to the primary key staff ID in this staff table. And then write a SQL script to return the number of devices stored in the database for the staff member with the first name Ali and last name Khan. And this is a 4 marks question. So for this question, feel free to use either method 1 or method 2 to answer this question. And if you are feeling fancy, you can try to use both methods as well. But definitely for exam purpose, you just have to use one of the methods. So just try your best and comment your answer down below. Thank you, and I will see you again then. Bye bye.